temporarily because of the drought in northern Nigeria. Trend in food security as in poverty may not be fully evident at national level. Therefore, an investigation of process such as trade liberalization that involve cross-country comparison should be sensitive, possibly important variability within the large economies. This implies the need for regional analysis to component country-level investigation. The case studies of Guatemala illustrate the intra-country dimension and missing from the national food security assessment. The definition of subnutrition, including the poor absorption and or poor biological use of nutrient consumed, the most convenient assumption for an agricultural and economic analysis would be ignore these factors. However, again, the current crisis in southern Africa serves as a reminder. There may be significant differences between the countries in these factors. They are changing the deteriorating health situation in South Africa and eroding nutritional status, not only with the recurrences of malaria, tuberculosis, and most evidently because of the rapid and spread HIV/AIDS, with an incidence of 25% more amongst the economically active and adult population. People may become more vulnerable, and so the economic more fragile and sensitive ever small shocks. There is also reason for reasoning and importance of transitory acute food security. The process of liberalization and transitory food security. Policy statements on food security give less and less prominence of transitory food insecurity and the risk of acute food crisis. The frequently retired assurances that there is a globally enough food to feed everyone is supported. Moreover, by the success in limiting the impact of the South Africa drought crisis in 1991 and 1992, such consideration may even suggest the risk of natural disaster, an economic shock, or a humanitarian problem resulting in serve food crisis and diminishing before accepting that comfortable conclusion that appropriate to re-examine the issue transitory of food insecurity as the possible link within liberalization. According to World Bank, 1986, the major sources of transitory food insecurity are year-to-year variations in international food prices, foreign exchange earning, and democratic food production household income. These are often related to temporary sharp reduction in a population ability to produce and purchase food and other essential, undermine long-term development and cause loss of human capital from which it takes years to recover. Since the report evidenced that natural disaster and conflict have both served short-term and persisting long-term negative effects has accumulated, the analysis is usually restated in terms of poverty rather than food security. As the 2000 and 2000 World Development Report, it is possible that liberalization increased the risk of shock that participates food crisis makes populations, at least during the transition in trade regime, more vulnerable. International grain markets were more violent in the 1990s than since the crisis period in the earlier 1970s. The US commentators have asked whether this volatility is associated with the regime changes linked to the ugly round of UR. Tropical commodity export prices are performing badly and apparently still following the long run previous singer downward trend. So friend, in the next video I will discuss the conclusion, multidimensional phenomena of the food security. If you like the video, like it, share it, so your friend can also take the information from my video. So thank you. Subscribe my channel. Thank you.